Good morning, student. Today I am going to start the first chapter of chemistry. The chapter name is matter. Student, matter may be defined as something that occupies space, possesses mass, and offers resistance to any stress. Matter has three states: solid, liquid, and gases. In this chapter, we will read the matter by the kinetic molecular theory. Now, the description of matter in terms of the motion of molecules or atoms or ions in it is called kinetic molecular theory of matter. Postulates of kinetic theory of matter. First is, the particles of matter are very small. The particles have spaces between them which we call the intermolecular spaces. Number three, the particles attract each other by force known as intermolecular force. And next is, the particles are constantly moving. These are the postulates of kinetic theory of matter, and this theory holds to three states, that is solid, liquid, and gases. Now, we know that in solid, the particles are closely packed and bound to each other firmly. Hence, solid have a fixed shape and definite volume. The particles in solids cannot move freely. Therefore, the particles in solids have little kinetic energy. In liquid, the particles are closely are not closely attached, packed, and they are actually loose packed. That is, intermolecular force of attraction is less than that in solid, so particles can easily move around within the liquid. Hence, liquid have no fixed shape and can flow from higher to lower level. As a result of space between particles in liquid, they have more kinetic theory than in a solid state. In gases, the intermolecular force of attraction is negligible. The particles move freely within considerable speed in any directions. So gases have no fixed shape or volume. In gases have very large kinetic energy. Our next topic is law of conservation of mass. Students, can you create or destroy matter? What do you think? During Deepavali, you bring a rocket, you light it, and you see the rocket goes in the sky and it vanishes. Well, here you destroyed rocket. That means, have you destroyed matter? Okay, when you light the rocket, you see sparks, you see pollution, you hear sound. So, you have not destroyed the rocket. Instead, you have converted it in different forms. The forms of pollution, spark, sound, and so on. So, matter can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only change its form. And this is known as law of conservation of mass. The concept of law of conservation of mass was taken as a specific case, as a law of conservation of mass, by the scientist named Antoine Lavoisier. To understand that, we do one experiment, that we will take calcium carbonate weighing 100 grams. Calcium carbonate, when dissolved, it change into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. 100 grams of calcium carbonate converted as a product, that is calcium oxide 56 gram and carbon dioxide 44 grams. That means mass remains same. Reactant is also 100 gram and product is also 100 gram. Mass in any chemical reaction is always conserved. Ancient Greek philosophy says that nothing comes from nothing. That is, nothing new is created and nothing is destroyed. Everything just changes its form.